Ewok is living proof that nothing in the world can hold you down. This deaf teenage girl has overcome the challenges and difficulties in her life to become one of the youngest pro Fortnite players on the planet. A single moment, which looked like something insignificant at the time, changed her life, so she took her chance and ran with it. Saleel Wheeler, known as Ewok Online, has probably one of the most inspirational and incredible stories in the world of Fortnite esports. She has managed to achieve so much, achieving over 300,000 followers on Instagram and over 250,000 followers on Twitch, and even becoming a member of FaZe, despite her age and being deaf. Ewok's beginnings on Twitch can be traced directly back to the first competitive event in Fortnite. She watched incredible, inspirational players like Ninja battle it out and decided that those were the dreams she was going to focus on attaining. She got herself a gaming PC on October 2018 and called herself Ewok after her dog, who supposedly looks like one of the furry creatures from Star Wars. No streamer is big from the beginning, and Ewok was no exception. Her start on Twitch was slow and grueling, but she stuck to it. She improved over time both at streaming and at Fortnite, and eventually managed to pick up 300 wins. Fast forward to March 2019. This was the month that Ewok's life was going to change forever. The month that all of her hard work up to that point would pay off. Everything in her life was about to change. Why? Because on March 7th, 2019, Tim the Tatman decided, on a whim, to host her on Twitch.
This girl I'm about to host chat, she's deaf, okay? So everyone go give her a lot of love, okay? I'll be back.
Tim the Tatman is one of the biggest Fortnite streamers on Twitch and also has a reputation for being one of the nicest streamers in the community. When you have that much influence and you're a nice guy, helping out smaller streamers is obviously something that you're going to want to do. With his thousands of viewers, Tim decided to host Ewok, meaning her stream would basically be played on Tim's channel to all the viewers that he already had in stream. And guess what? It was a success beyond her imagination. As Tim's viewers started rolling into Ewok's stream, the young deaf player didn't know how to react. The emotions were clear on her face as she began to feel overwhelmed. She was beyond ecstatic and even began to cry. At the beginning of her stream that day, Ewok had just under 1,000 followers, a position many new channels find themselves in for an incredibly long time. But Ewok was propelled past it at a rapid pace. Between March 7th and March 10th, her follower count rose from under 1,000 to over 10,000. Everything kind of just snowballed from that point. The media latched onto this incredible, emotional story of a small deaf streamer being raised up by one of the biggest esports names on the planet. Ewok's name was plastered everywhere, not just by the fact that she was actually pretty good at Fortnite, but the fact that she was so good at the game even though she had a handicap of being deaf. All the mainstream and social media attention pushed her follower count to over 100,000 on Twitch in less than a year on the platform. One of the people that watched Ewok's stream on that day was none other than the Atlanta Falcons backup quarterback, Kurt Benkert. Neither of them knew it then, but just 3 months later, the pair would meet in real life at the second Fortnite Pro-Am tournament. They started to train with one another before the event and eventually ended up becoming pretty good friends. Kurt Benkert even started to learn sign language so that they could communicate together via a video chat at the tournament. When Ewok started her journey on Twitch, it had been her dream to face off against pro players on their own turf, and now that was the opportunity that she had. The streamer that had started her dream, Ninja, would be competing at the event alongside other massive streamers, including Tim the Tatman. It was her very first time competing in an offline event, something that she was incredibly nervous about before the tournament. While the two didn't end up winning the tournament, Ewok is said to have one of the greatest moments of the entire event.
clean it up, but we weren't done there. Now, something got to note. Look how smart this is. She ends up having so many shields and the storm flip, recognizes she's by the zone. So what does she do? Tunnels her way in, juggles it on, ends up getting another knock. But now look, she has all the supplies and everything she needs to end up making it into the end game. A great finish there, a top 10 performance. Ewok and Kurt have...
She worked alongside her teammate to take out Dr. Lupo before she chased Lupo's teammate Jordan Fisher through two rifts and more than one wind tunnel to finally take him out. The entire chase was caught on stream, and while they didn't end up winning, they did go on to raise $20,000 that would be donated to the National Association of the Deaf Youth Programs. This association invests in young deaf people to try and improve their quality of life. While she was worried about what might happen at such a large event, Ewok walked away from it overjoyed at how things had gone. She was especially impressed with how Epic Games accommodated her deafness. They invited her on stage after the block party to make sure that the logistics of having an ASL interpreter around would work out, and that it was effective before the tournament had started. Overall, her Pro-Am experience was incredible, but it was just the beginning of her journey. A month later, Ewok would appear at another Pro-Am event, this time alongside Jordan Fisher. This event took place at the Fortnite World Cup, and unfortunately she wasn't able to win, but was able to bring home another $20,000 for her chosen charity. After the tournament was over, it seemed as if Ewok's life was about to change all over again. She had done a lot to come as far as she had. On Twitch, she had almost 200,000 followers. She had eliminated some of the best pros in Fortnite, and now she was going to become the first female member of FaZe Clan. The announcement was made on July 28th, when she was presented as a new FaZe team member to an incredibly appreciative crowd of FaZe members. She announced the move on Twitter herself a little while afterwards, and the responses from the Fortnite community were incredible. Banks, the owner of FaZe, said that Ewok was an incredible inspiration, and that he was glad they held out as long as they did to make her the first female player for FaZe because she was perfect. Ewok has managed to do what many may have thought impossible. Even though she is deaf, she has become one of the best Fortnite players in the world, even going as far to compete for a major esports team. Ewok was born deaf, and it's something that she's never let get in the way of her success. In fact, as far as Fortnite is concerned, she thinks it might actually have been an advantage. Fortnite has a very interesting way to help accommodate players who are deaf. That's the Fortnite Sound Visualizer. For someone who is able to hear, this might be seen as a pretty weird way to play, because when you enable the sound visualizer, the game sound is actually turned off. Instead, you get to see alerts on your screen when anything makes a sound in-game near you. This was originally designed for mobile platforms, but in the Season 5 update, it was added to consoles and PCs as well. Ewok has said that the sound visualizer that Epic added to the game has been extremely helpful, and thinks that the addition to the game hasn't just made it possible for her to play on the same level, but maybe even at a higher level than some players. Instead of putting effort into trying to hear where enemies might be creeping around, she's allowed to focus purely on the visuals of the game to seek out where her enemies are moving. Ewok has always been the sort of person that forges her own path. While she started streaming on Twitch and grew on the platform rapidly, she decided to make the choice to join streamers like Ninja and Shroud in a move over to an exclusive streaming contract with Mixer. This deal shocked a ton of people at the time. Sure, Ewok was pulling in solid viewing numbers on Twitch, but she was nowhere near as popular as streamers like Ninja. Despite being a smaller streamer, this move made a ton of sense.
I will be streaming exclusively on Mixer.
Ewok has already managed to gain a level of viewership on Mixer that is on par with where she was on Twitch when she joined up with FaZe Clan. She has over 140,000 followers on the streaming platform, and while this wouldn't have been overly impressive on Twitch, it means that she's already the 34th most followed streamer on the site. And this is just the beginning of her very, very successful career ahead. Who knows? Ewok has never let difficulties slow her down in the past, so the sky's the limit for this young Fortnite superstar. Not only does Ewok have a Mixer stream, but she also has a YouTube channel, which in the last month has started to become increasingly more active. Ewok tends to post montages and highlight videos, but has also posted a video of her playing alongside her dad in a Q&A video. Since joining FaZe, Ewok has been pretty inactive on the competitive Fortnite side of things, but that's likely a side effect of her age. While the World Cup allowed players that were 13 and older to play for a shot at winning the prize, most esports events require players to be at least 16 years old to compete, which included events like the Fortnite Fall Skirmish last year. We've seen her compete in Pro-Am tournaments and outplay some of the best players on the planet, and we've seen her dominate online on her stream. But so far, Ewok hasn't been given the chance to truly prove herself in a competitive setting. Clearly, when FaZe saw her, it was an investment in Ewok's future because they see potential in what she could become. Ewok may be young, she may be deaf, but she doesn't let either of those things keep her down. She became one of the youngest players to be signed by a pro team and the very first girl to play for FaZe Clan. She dominated her opponents at Pro-Am events. She became one of the fastest growing streamers on Twitch and Mixer in 2019. If you guys don't already follow her, you absolutely must. Go check her out right now. She's an absolute pleasure to watch.